Patricia Alice Albrecht. Swimming with a Loaded Gun. Randy was a lake I'd never swum. Steel blue eyes, brass colored hair. I didn't care that his arms were tough, dry, and barnacled into coarse curls. His beauty lured my heart, and with it my hearing, for I dismissed the warning from my life guardian not to jump in. I was the new cheerleader up north. He was home on leave, a long way from Camp Lejeune. We'd met at a basketball game before he headed well west of Hawaii, and I clung to the buoy that he might not return alive. Then, before we even had a chance to get our feet wet, I moved downstate. While he filled his life preserver with ammunition, our love letters were leaves in the wind, skimming the surface of lust. And when he came to see me again, we were surrounded in the lighthouse of Dunkin' Donuts, where I had to work, stealing finger touches between steaming cups of coffee, our hands capsized over French crullers, and for a brief moment, we went under the cover of snow out in his dad's sedan, until I had to surface behind the counter again, starched and cheerful, before he left for duty. For a year, our letters were tugboats, churning through personal seas of displacement. My first semester at Central Michigan, he on front lines he never told me about. We dismissed talk of my father's sudden death, the murky bottom of battlefields, and planned his homecoming. My nightgown, a red flag of distress, was ironed for days before I thought we'd set sail, until finally, on leave, he arrived at my dorm room, a worn and hungry civilian, overly eager to dive in. But I was not prepared for the grappling hook that trolled my mind away from my body, away from his. The only time we lay together, I was a log, too young and green and sodden with the lead of Catholic guilt. I condemned the fishtail kick of my legs and feared for days I might be pregnant for how close he came to the place I let him touch. I'd sunk before I ever floated. A flotsam of feelings circled us like hungry fish, caught in our own eddies. We drifted apart. The stains of mortal sinners never wash as clean, and I overlooked the hands that were more at home in killing grounds than paddling toward salvation. He disappeared in Nam. I hid my spark under towels of guilt, sure I was the punctured life raft that failed to rescue him. For decades, I sank and swam through men that were floating islands. Years later, I roiled seasick when I learned Randy survived. He'd hooked the prettiest mermaid from our small town, then beached his dreams in Phoenix. The prettiest girl. Then air bubbles, thinking maybe my body knew more than my mind after all. Now, I could stop burying my own treasure. But Phoenix? A desert that dry-docked his emotions? Or had the anchor of long-choked secrets forced him to pull the trigger on his handgun in front of his two small boys?